फोर ए प्लस 12 बी माइनस 36 सी माइनस 14 डी प्लस 60 ई। ओके वन टू थ्री फोर फाइव। ओके okay, so here first we will take one example, a very simple example, a linear problem. Say suppose a plant is working like this, and suppose each coefficient here is just the parameters we have in this plant are the variables that can change their value is a b c d e. okay, so five parameters we have, and the plant find out that their working is completely in linear model, and they come up with this mathematical model. Okay, so now our objective will be, because each part represents the cost involved in that part, okay, and minus here represents that, okay, it is giving profit or earning, rather the positive value here represents the expense. Okay, so the plant want to optimize, like what should value of a b c d e should be such that the overall cost for running this plant should be as low as possible, as minimum as possible. And the plant give this information also, that the maximum value for a that we can take is in the upper bound, that is 100, and the minimum value of a we can take is minus 10. Similarly, the minimum value of B I can take is 20, minimum value of C I can take is 30, and so like this. So in lower bound, in matrices, I will define all the minimum values I can take of all these parameters. And in upper bound, I will define what the maximum value they can take in the upper bound. And I have to figure out what values should fit this part so that the overall function f will be as minimum as possible. So I have to minimize it. So any optimization, whether it is genetic or TLBO or any other optimization, the main objective is to minimize. So for example, if in some cases I want to maximize something, so just I have to, what I have to do, I'll put a bracket and put a minus sign so that maximum will become minimum. So this logic we can use in creating the cost function. So first I'll go step by step. First I will create a cost function, and then I will export this cost function into TLBO part. So first here I'll make the cost function in MATLAB. So I'll go to home, take a function, delete everything, and say the name I will change it to cost function.
बाहर है कृपया।
And here the parameter is only x. Let me So here the variable is x and output is f. Now first I will define my cost function. So my f, which is my cost function, is it is like this. F is equal to 4 into x1. Here a will be represented as, like, x will represent a complete set of solution. So x first element represent a value plus 12 into x2. So second element of x will represent the value of b plus, sorry, minus 36 into c. So it will be x3. So the third element of x3 will represent the value of c, and so does 14 into x4. So the fourth element of x3 will represent the d value, and the last will represent the value of e, x5. X5. Okay. So now we have created our cost function. I'll save it with the same name, cost function. Okay, and minimize it. Now first, I'll make you go through line by line of the TLB algorithm. I'll explain everything, and then we'll be using in our way. So I'll open the TLB script first. And to understand this TLB algorithm logic, first I'll discuss some basics which we have discussed in the first class. Suppose I have to create a random population of 10 samples, because here in our case, each sample of solution should contain 5 variables, right? And we want to create, say, 4 number of different population. So how I can do this? I can use random function, say random, and first say I need 6 number of this thing, and I have, sorry, 4 number of this one and 3 number of, sorry, and we have 5 number of variables. So number of variable will come to this side, and number of population will come to this side. So here it is giving you a single this thing, column wise random populations. Okay, CLC. Suppose I want to create this thing, a random number between 5 and 10. So the method will be 5 plus the difference, that is random, the difference between the higher value minus the lower value, 5, comma, and the number of times. Like here, I want to generate 4 population with, say, 5 number of variables. So forget about 5 because I cannot show everything in a complete matrix. So I'll take a single this thing. So here it will generate you all the random number between 5 and 10. 5 plus 5. Sorry, this one I'll take it outside. I'll multiply it. Control X. Mistake. I will do. 1 minute. This one I'll take it outside, not required. I'll multiply the difference here. Because random number will always give me any number between 0 and 1. So if that number is multiplied to the difference of the lower bound and upper bound, so then it will give me all random number between those limits. So here we have all the random number between 5 and 6. And let me change the MATLAB format also. Format short. Because See, suppose again I will explain this. I want to generate a random number, a 5 random number that should be between 16 and 19. Okay, so the algorithm logic will be, first I have to add the minima part, then whatever the difference is there between 16 and 19, 19 and 16, I'll multiply that difference with the random number. So say suppose I want to generate 5 row and 1 this thing column random number. So now it will give me all 5 random number between 16 and 19. Okay, so we'll take our example also this side, and as per this example we'll be making our TLBO. So the first thing which is just for the clear to make erase everything. The second one, the line number 4 which you are seeing here is for the lower bound matrix. So because in our case we have 5 parameters and the lower bound goes like this, so I will edit all this thing as per the new simple algorithm which I want to run it. So first a lower bound is 10, then 20, then 30, then minus 90, minus 150. Okay, similarly I'll update the upper bound information. So the number of elements in the lower bound and upper bound should be equal to your number of parameters or variables that we have to optimize, 10 and 60. So now we have completed up to line number 5. Now in line number 6, I stored the function. So this step I hope is clear. We just have updated the cost function in our variable 6. Now we want to create a TLB algorithm, which what it will going to do, it will create in every iteration 10 number of population, random population, and each population will contain 5 set of values for A, B, C, D, E, and it will be checking, okay, if what if this value is fit to cost function, then how much value I'm getting, and try to minimize it. And total I'm doing 20 times iteration for this purpose. Okay, like 20 times I will generate the 10 random populations. So I'll remove semicolon so to show everything up to here, what actually we did. Yes. So if I run this one, add to path. Okay, so you can see here that we have generated the lower bound, we have generated the upper bound, the prob variable is dependent upon our, it is a kind of a function handler, and it takes the value from the cost function, and number of p, number of population I'm generating 10, and total iteration is 20. Now the this one, as we have discussed in session 1, it will create a 10 it will going to generate 10 matrix size of having 10 rows and 1 column, and each value will be NaN. Okay, so that what happens when I'll update this f with some value, that particular indices of f will be updated, rest other will be as NaN. So let me show you on the command prompt first what exactly happens. So f is equal to, say h is equal to NaN, and then say 3 rows and 1 column. Okay, if I hit enter, it will generate a matrix of 3 rows having not a number type data type, and if I update only h2 value to say some 5, then only that value will be updated, rest will be in NaN form, so that later on I can easily see which value was updated and which was not even being touched. If I put 0 and 1s, then again I might be confused that yes, whether it is the result of TLB optimization or just it didn't change anything. So that's the reason why I'm using NaN for creating a dummy matrix here. So the purpose of F is equal to NaN here is to store the value of population sample, like what cost function, cost value they are generating. And all those values I'm storing in F variable. Actually, somebody's mic is on. Yeah. So the basic purpose of F is to store all the outcome of the 10 samples, the 10 population sample, to store in the F variable. Now I take a best filter variable so that in each iteration, out of this 10 population, which population is giving the lowest value of the cost that I want to store into my best filter variable, so that after the end of this thing optimization, I can see it. Now here in line number 16, the purpose of using length command on LB is to count the number of parameters or the input variables which I have to optimize. So this one I'll okay. So up to here I'll run it again. Step. CLC. Stop and run. Okay, so here you can see that on our command window, we have d is equal to 5, representing 5 number of parameters, and best filter and f function, I kept it NaN in the beginning stage. Now, in line number 18, we are creating a random population. And the formula we use is ripmat, because we have 5 variables here. So I have to use ripmat so that each time 5 set of copies should be created. Okay, so I'll explain you how this thing is working. So first in ripmat, I pass the lower bound information. So this logic is same as I told you, like if I want to create a random number between 16 and 19, so first I have to add the lower bound, the lowest value. So ripmat LB is the lower value, and it should be equal to the number of population, the rows, okay, and one, that is for the column. So if I use, let me show you on command prompt, ripmat home, I'll use ripmat, say I have five number of population, or say I'll take a little bit less, 3 only, so that I can show it in this screen only. And I need total 10 number of population and one. Okay, this thing I have to add it to the difference, that is I'll copy this one and I put it manually, some difference. So the difference, say, is here I'll create a matrix for 3, 1, 2, 3 for lower bound. Sorry, that was the upper bound. So lower bound I'll create minus 5, minus 10, and minus 20. So this is the difference. Lower bound also, I'll put it here only. Control C, Control V, comma 3, comma 1. And number of population, whatever I want to generate, say 10, and 10 here. And we have only 3 variables. Okay, somewhere we are doing some mistake. Anyways, I'll show it output here only. I'll just remove this one. semicolon, and I'll put a breaker here and remove the break sign. And now I'll run it. Okay, so on the screen you can see how we are generating the population. So column 1, column 2, column 3, and column 4 and column 5. So column 1 is the variable for A, column 2 for B, for C, D, and E. And as you can compare it with the initial this thing. So column A can only have a value between minus 10 to 100. So in all these cases, whatever 10 random population we have generated, each value lies between minus 10 to 100. Similarly, if we pay attention towards the last, which is the E column, which is our this one, the fifth column, from minus 150 to 60 only we can have any values, acceptable values. So here we have all random number which are in between minus 150 to 60. So this way we are generating random populations. So each row of this population represents a set of solution. Okay, yeah, this set of solution may be giving different cost values. Our target is to find the minimum of all this things. Nice again. Now, in line number 20 to 22, what we are doing, for every population, for every sample solution, we are calculating the cost value and we are storing it into a F. So I'll put breaker here. So I'll put breaker on line number 24 and I'll run this thing and let's see what happens. Put debugging. Yeah. Step. Okay. So you can see once I executed the population, then in best filter, okay, I didn't put this semicolon, that's why. So press run. Okay. So you can see here, line number 20 to 22, we have evaluated the cost function for each population set, and total we have 10 cost function. Out of this, there will be one minimum, which I'll click on a step so that it will execute line number 24 and show me which is the best value. So the best value is minus 1.3223 10 to the power 4. Okay, so which is this one, the population at the seventh position, giving me the best solution right now. Now we will go to the teacher phase. So the algorithm act like this, that in first iteration we find the best solution among the random population that act as a teacher. Okay, and that teacher will train the other specimen and improve their efficiency. So other specimen will be acting as a students. So here in line number 29, we are entering into the teacher phase. So we have to put it into a nested loop in which the first loop will represent the total number of iterations we want to do for optimization. And line number 28 represents. So where we were at line number 28. Okay. So after line number 28, as we have selected the best this thing, the teacher, and who will be the best teacher, which has the highest best result out of the population. So our teacher is at the seventh position, minus 1.323. Okay, and the teacher phase algorithm goes like this. So first, what we are doing, whatever random population we have generated, like this one, okay, so I'll take the mean of this random population. So this will act, it will create a new population, which I will call as a mean population. After adding it and dividing it by 10, I'll get a mean number for each parameters A, B, C, D, E. So that will act as a mean population here. And in line number 32, I'm just taking the best teacher, which I can use a minima function. So minima of F, where F is what? F is this value, which is taking, where is F? 1 minute. f f f yeah, here we have the f. So out of the matrix of f, I'm taking the best solution which I can get it from the minima function. So minima is this one, so that will be loaded in, the value will be loaded in v, and the indices at what position it occurred, that will be loaded is in ind variable. Okay, now the x best here, x best is the set of best population, the best population which is giving me the best cost function, that I am storing it, because once I get the indices value, that indices value if I pass to my population set, I will get the complete set of that population which was the best in giving me the least cost function. Okay, so here in line number 13 I generated the mean, in line number 33 I select the teacher, okay, the best this thing population. And then as per the TLBA algorithm, this is that you have to create a teacher factor which is nothing, just a random number, okay, which can be random integer number, which can be either one or two in any case. So I'll remove here also all the suppression, and I will show up to this step what we are going, what we are doing. So quit debugging and run. Okay, a step. So x mean, you can see here that we have calculated the x mean, which is not there in the population. So this value will not be there in the population. And now if I step next, then I calculated the value. So the value is minus something 9000, and it occurred at indices 6 of the function. So here is my function at sixth position, it occurred. Yeah, at sixth position, I have the least that thing, minus 9000 something, which is here. Okay, so this value occurred at sixth. Okay, and I have the x mean, which is the mean of all the a, b, c, d, e. I'll go a step next. So here through this command, line number 35, now it generated a random integer which is 2. So as this one also we have discussed in the session one, that randi function creates a random integer between the bounds. So if I say, if I give a bound say 5, so it will create a one row and one column, it means one element it will create between 1 and 5. Okay, so with this we can create like this. So as per the theory, we have to take only random integer between 1 and 2. Now in line number 37, we are creating a new species. Okay, how we are creating it? With the use of this logic, in which I will take the ith, say suppose the first student, the first specimen in the population which will act as a student. So first specimen I will take, and I will take any, say one random number. And this will, I'm going to add into the x best minus tf into x mean. So to create a new species, it is as per the theory. It is, I'm not taking as per my hypothetical guess. Okay, it was as per the theory that we are using this algorithm to generate a new species, which should not be the part of the population. And once we create this new species, let me show you what we are getting after generating this new species. One minute, I have to run it again. So I'll remove it from here. Okay, I'll put breaker here and run it again. Quit debugging, run. So we are here at the x new. So let me show you what new species we are getting. So here we are getting this new species as per this line number 37 algorithm. Okay, so this new species, now I want to compare. Okay, like whether it is improved version or it is just the poor version. Okay, so before doing the comparison, because this algorithm can assign a value which might not be there in the inbound and outbound, so before checking and loading the function, I have to check the bound condition. So this is generally the algorithm which we use for checking the bound. Say suppose let me go to paint. Yeah, I'll explain here first. So if I have to check a number, say I will create a dummy variable here, 100. Okay, I'll take a number only. 110, 300, 190, 200, and 61. Okay. So suppose, just imagine that the algorithm creates a random new population like this. Okay. But because it shouldn't be outbound, so what I'm doing, I'm writing an algorithm which will make it inbound. Okay, and the algorithm goes like this. So I'll put it as a kind of x new here. X new. So x new is this. X new is equal to this. So the algorithm will go like this. X new. 1 minute. X new is equal to minima of upper bound and the x new. Okay, so what it will going to do, it will compare. Okay, like in first column of the upper bound I have 100 value, and in first column of the x new I have 110. So out of these two, who is the minima? So the minima is 100. So 100 will be updated to x new. So it will going to it will going to change this value and make it 100. Now for the second one, 350 is there. Who is minima? X new is minima. So it will retain. So the new value will become 100, then 300, and in the second case, 200 and 190. X new is having the minima, so it will retain 190. Fourth case, 10 and 200. So the upper bound 10 is the minima, so 10 will remove this 200, and this way we can make correction of the new offspring. Okay, if it is going outside the boundary, because we don't have to cross the boundary, so we are using this logic, minima. Now similarly, to curtain it from the lower bound, we are using the max logic. So whichever is maxima, okay, that will retain. So this will correct it. So here, if you see, then let me minimize this one. So the upper bound, if we compare 100, 350, 200, 10, and sorry, yeah, 10 and 60. So everything is below the lower bound, upper bound. So this will have same as it is. But in case of lower bound, if I run it, x new, do we have any changes? No, we don't have any changes, because this new offspring is in between the bounds, the upper bounds and lower bounds. Now I'm going to go for the next one, which in which I will calculate the new cost function with the fnew command. So new cost function is coming to minus 1.723, which if I compare to the previous best solution, where I have 1.257 10 to the power 4, and now I have minus 1.1, which is not best compared to the teacher we have selected in our population. So here we are checking if the new population is less than from the best one which we have selected, then only it will going to update itself. It will update the offspring, the population elements, and it will update the cost function also. But here it doesn't happen. So MATLAB will directly jump to line number 48. So if I run it, okay, it will, okay, it find it, I guess. Line number this, fi is equal to fnew. Okay, 1 minute, I have to run it again because this is a problem. I'll come here first and then I'll jump it, yeah. So fnew is created, which is minus 1.054 10 to the power 4. And let us check with the best solution, which is 8 10 to the power 3, minus 8 10 to the power 3. And here we have minus 1 10 to the power 4. So obviously this new offspring is lesser in size because it has more negative value. So here MATLAB will go inside this loop and it will update the fnew as well as the population also. So the complete population, the sixth row will be updated. Okay, this one part is updated. Once we complete the teacher phase, we enter into the learner phase. And in learner, what happens? We randomly select one partner out of the population. Okay, and we have to make it sure that partner should not be the teacher. Okay, because random number can give a random integer, and sometime it may happen that it will give suppose 6 again, which was the index value of the teacher. So this is what we are doing in line number 54 to 56. We are checking if it is equal to the indices of the teacher, then keep on generating random this thing number for the partner or for the student selection, so that we should get a unique student only, not the same teacher, okay, to act as a student and go for the below algorithm. So here also I'll remove all the semicolon first. Yeah, quit, run. Okay, so step by step we'll go. Now here the value of p, let's see, our generated value of p is equal to 4, and we will see that whether this p is equal to 4 should not be equal to the indices. Yes, it is not equal to indices, which was earlier 7. So at 7 position we have the teacher. Now we have p4, which will act as a student. So MATLAB won't come inside this line number 55. It will directly jump. Okay, because we have a student here to whom we have to train. Now, this is the algorithm we use for training of the student. Okay, so if the value of the student, obviously, if it is fi, yeah, if it is less than this, then I have to use this algorithm for updating a new, for generating a new offspring. Okay, or if it is not, if it is greater, then I have to use this as a algorithm for generating a new offspring. And once we generate a new offspring, we have to do the same thing again. We have to check it for the inbounds, that like whether the new offspring is into the same bound or not. And let's check it here. So it compare here that yes, it is not. So we'll update a new spring, and new spring it generated. So here we have a new offspring. So now this new offspring will have a cost function, its own cost function, that is minus 6 10 to the power 3. So which is not as low as, I guess, because we have 10 to the power 4. So in comparison to it, it is quite greater. So here nothing updation will happen. And it will just jump learner phase. Okay. Line number 51. Okay, let's complete this step first. So it get a new population here. And then it will check for the inbounds. If any changes is there, it will going to update, but I guess it is again into the limits, so nothing will change. Now it will calculate the cost function, and if that cost function is less than, then it will update the population, and it will keep on doing it like this for n is equal to 50, whatever the population is. So in our case, the population was approximately not approximately, it is exactly 10 times. So up to that iteration, it will keep on doing it, update it, and then it will come out of this one, and then again a teacher will be selected like this. It will keep on doing it. So I'll remove the breaker here, and now I'll make it to complete all this loop and show me the result. Okay, so this one I'll show it here what it is there. At every iteration, okay, the best population is selected, and its best value, which is the cost function, is loaded into the best filter variable. Okay, and at the end of each line, I'll be displaying the value also. And once this loop completes, we have the best value of the cost function and what set of value I should use. So let's run this script complete and see what we have. So here MATLAB solved this thing, and it gives the best solution will be to use -10, 20, 200, 10, and -50. And in this case, the best fitness function is -16140. Okay, and let's check the equation. So we know that from that it is a common sense that if we multiply with a positive number, a negative number, okay, or as low as possible, because it is linear here, right? So it will be having a low value. So in order for B case, for example, like here, we have the lower bound -10. So if -10, I'll multiply to A, so it will become more negative, right? And in case of 12, because it is positive, so I have to multiply least positive number, because at the end I want my F to be minima as much as possible. But in the third case, if you see, it is -36. So -36 should be multiplied to a positive, highly positive number. So in case of C, we have the upper bound 200. Okay, let me remove this one XNew so that you might not confused. This is not there. Brush, white brush. Okay, I'll take shapes. Fine. Select image, Control X, Control C. 1 minute, let me zoom. Select, Control X, Control A, delete, Control B. Yeah, so this is our this thing. So here we have multiplied with the maximum positive number so that a maximum negative can be added. So does in -14 also. So maximum number was 10, and this way. So here it gives very quick result, and it gives us two graphs. So here these two graphs have some meaning. The first graph shows the value, what negative value we are getting here. And the second graph is a logarithmic level graph, which checks like once it is saturated also, is there any improvement? If there is any improvement, then it will show here, or if there is no improvement, it will merge to zero axis line. Okay, so we have like, that's why we have in our code, let me show you. We have taken subplot and semi-logigraph. So this one, it is checking the logarithmic part. Okay. I will take 1 minute emergency break, and then I'll continue.
Okay, Jay. Attendance is available. The link of attendance is available. Please fill it.
So the best example with very simple cost function. Now, if I change my cost function, say my cost function is this, and let me make it from linear to non-linear. So first I will write it here, the equation for non-linear. See, my f now becomes, okay, I have to take black. So that is not working. F, yeah. So f is equal to, say, a into sine b multiplied by exponential c plus d, or c divided by d. Okay, a b c d e also we have, and plus say e square. Okay, now if I changed my cost function to this, then we will see what outcome it gives us for all a b c d to have a minima result, the global minima. So I'll write it like this. First is x1 multiplied by sine x2 multiplied by exponential of x3 divided by x4. Okay. Plus x5 square. Okay, so I just updated my cost function, and now with this updated cost function I'll run the TLBO script. Okay, TLB. Okay, and keeping the inbound and outbound same. Okay, in that case what I can get as a solution, I want to see. Okay, I run it, and here it dropped to -3.5 × 10⁻¹. So it is too much, so I have to make it a very simple. It went too much deep. So cost function, I think this exponential part is creating the problem. I'll make it cost, giving too much high amplitude. Okay, TLBU done. So the best solution MATLAB is giving us, that in this case the best solution will be at minus the cost function value will be -67.5994, and it will come at when a value is 85, b value is 296, c value is 200, d value is -80, and e value is 0.513. But as I told you that we have the control here, what if happens if I increase the number of population and keep the iteration 20 only? So now we will compare with the previous result. Okay, so we have even more improved this thing, because earlier it was -60 something, but now we have even more improved value, which is -97. Okay, and this I can get it here. So as we increase the number of population or number of iterations, so TLBO converges very aggressively towards the solution. But because we have put a finite limit here at how much iteration it can do, so it will find the best solution in that iteration and give it to you. So if I increase iteration up to 50, having a same 100 population, then I will compare whether it improves from -97 or not. Okay.
Because you expect this work to have relevance even 10 years from
now. Sorry, ma'am, I cannot hear you.
No, sir, so, I wanted.
Here we have the improved efficiency. Now we have -99, which is improved version of -97. Yeah, ma'am, ask me a question.
What I wanted to know is this population and iteration.
Okay.
Definitely, if I increase, I'll get good results. But
yes,
where do I stop? How do I know?
Ma'am, you do this thing until you find that whatever the best result you are getting, it has no significant amount of change. Say, suppose for me, if I'm a manufacturer, then this result is giving me a dimension. So I can know up to 0.1 value, it has the information is relevant to me. But if the change is affecting third decimal place or second decimal place, it won't be relevant to me. So I'll be interested only if it changes above 0.1 value. So till then, I'll be continuing doing it until I see that there is no change further in the improvement. Like say in the first example, ma'am, we started with 67, right? This minus 67. Then once I increase the number of population to 100, I get minus 97. Now I doubled the iteration, okay? I get only increment of minus 2 times. So let me do it this way. If I increase the number of population, or sorry, just the iteration to 500 times, and now I will see, like running through all this high level of iteration, but at the end I'm getting the result. What best result is there compared to minus 99.9 something, whatever the result. Okay. Now in the problem, it will ask you for the fitness function. Okay, which will copy the same name, fitness function. I think we put with @. Okay, I'll put with @. Let's see. Now number of variables. So as per this, we have, it is trying to solve cost function this. So total number of variable is 5. So I'll put 5 here. Okay. And the lower bound and upper bound information. So I'll go back here again. I'll copy this one and I'll put in lower bound, and in upper bound, I'll copy this part in upper bound. Okay. Now, before starting this one, I have some options, like in TLBU, like we are controlling the iteration and number of population. So here also we do have the same. Okay. So you can leave it to a default where it says that if you're using default, then it will use 50, okay, or otherwise it will take 200. And initial population is also by default, they have some 100, I guess. So this way, if you want to manually override it, you can specify it, like population size. Say I want initial population, I'll specify here, I want 50 as initial population. Okay, selection, reproduction. Oh. Crossover, I'll set, leave it initial penalty factor, fine. Generation number, use, specify generation number. So generation number, I'll put 50. And the output, what kind of graph I want to see? I want to see the best fitness graph, the scores, best individual. You can turn this one on. And level of display, if I want to see at each iteration, I can turn on the level of display. And once after doing all this initial settings, okay, I can start the genetic algorithm. It will take 10 second time to launch, and soon you will see on the screen some multiple graphs. One minute, I'll take default only. Give a default start. Okay. Yeah. So here we have a solution. By default, it is taking 200 number of population size, and with that few iteration, it able to give us this result, that the best value is minus 100 and individual values will be this one. Okay. Now, if I do the same thing, because here I put so much result viewing thing. Now I'll put semicolon everywhere and I will compare this two analysis by giving even wider range so that we can see who converts faster. And let's see. Best printed, best fitness.
In line number 71.
In line number
71. There will be a semicolon.
Okay. Yes. Semicolon, correct. And tab. So this one also, okay, fine. Num to STI, yeah. Okay. Best solution I want to see. Okay, fine. Okay. Now, what I will do, I'll try to diversify this thing. Okay, 100. Minus 100. Okay, let's do it this way. Okay, first I'll make a cost function that we can easily compare it. Say suppose error, I have to calculate. What simple example should take? X squared minus this. Okay, let's first compare with this one and then we will change the equation, or let's make it the simple one first. Whatever in paint we have analyzed this one, we will make it this first and then we'll compare this one. So say suppose if this is my example, so the cost function will become 4 into x1, which we can easily see, then plus 12 into x2 minus 36 into x3 minus 14 into x4 plus 16 into x5. Okay. 4x 12b minus 36 minus 14 and 60, correct. Control S and I'll go to my this thing, this one. Okay, and try to run first with this and then. Okay, so first for comparison analysis we will make same for both. So whatever in genetic algorithm we have, total number of iteration, same number of iteration will provide in this also. So by default it is taking 50 as mentioned here. So we'll provide population size 50 and number of generations, it is somewhere around by default is 100 number of generations are there. So This is not required, just 50 only it will going to convert. So let's run this one. So it just converts right now. At the moment I click, it just solved it. And in logarithmic, if I pay attention, then it tells me that it able to converge it at hardly fifth iteration only. The right side graph, when it touches the zero, it shows the convergence. So it takes only 5 iteration to solve this problem. And in case of genetic algorithm, if I start, then I can see it is taking okay some iterations, more iterations than compared to TLBO, because you can see when it is at 50 also, it didn't converge properly and still it is like trying to flat. Okay, so the best value it able to converge at something where we are not finding any appreciable amount of change is at 250, somewhere around 200 to 250 iterations. Okay, and here it received this value -16. So this value we will going to note. So the best value is -16140 at an individual. If we see each solution, then the solution for A is -9.997, which you can obviously guess it orally also, that if this is the case, then I know that to minimize it, I have to multiply with the least number. So that will be -10. But here in genetic algorithm, I'm getting only -9.997. And in the second one, it is an error. It should not exceed the upper bound, but it is. Here we can see it is going 20.002, which it should not go, but again it is very small, so we can neglect that error, no problem. And rest other are fine, not an issue. But in the first we have still, it can further optimize, but this is not the case with the TLBO, because if you look at the this part, if I run it again, then you can see here it takes less amount of time and it will give you exact and accurate solution. Okay, so you can track this thing with other different complex function also, and you'll find that yes, it converges relatively faster than genetic algorithm. So I hope this is clear.